I'm sorry. I'm just having a little conversation here with Lawrence Fishburne in the break. He has one of the most famous voices in Hollywood, and now it's on full display as the supervillain, the Beyonder, in the animated series Marvel's Moon Girl and Devil Dinosaur. And please give it up for the Lawrence Fishburne.
Good morning.
You are a renaissance man. I enjoyed a little chat there and
talking about
various things.
Yeah, I love comic books. I've always loved comic books. I'm an executive producer on this show, creator of this show, Moon Girl and Devil Dinosaur, about a young girl named Lunella Lafayette, who will be the first African-American teenage superhero in the Marvel Universe.
Oh, and see, because I love how you say, executive producer, you are the reason this show is coming to life. Mm-hmm. It's taken a couple of years.
About 5 years.
What was it about it?
It's you can't be what you can't see. Mm. So, you know, I mean, Wakanda Forever, right? It's great, right? It's a superhero movie, and all five of the leads are black women. This is very much in that vein. Our lead is a 13-year-old African-American girl who lives on the Lower East Side with her family and runs a roller rink. And she just happens to have a 50-foot T-Rex as a sidekick.
Just so happens. I know. And you get to play a supervillain.
And I get to play...
You like to tap into that side of you?
Yeah, I mean, you know, listen, I was saying to you before, you know, like Mel Blanc, who was a great actor who voiced Bugs Bunny and Daffy Duck and all these people, was one of my heroes, and people like Dawes Butler. I've always played around with my voice, and so this gives me an opportunity to do something that's really fun and really different.
And playing around with your voice, you actually sing.
That's what they call it. I wouldn't call
Come
it singing, but that's what they're saying it is.
But everyone has like a little theme song. Many of the characters have.
The Lunella, we have Rafael Sadiq as our music producer. We were really blessed to get him. So there's a whole sort of mixtape thing that happens in almost every episode. And it's got a really sort of mishmash kind of style in terms of animation. It's been influenced by a lot of different things, and we've sort of, like New York is a combination of a lot of things.
True.
So we also wanted to reflect the Lower East Side in a really kind of honest and authentic way, and we've been able to do that. And I guess the theme of our show is one girl can make a difference.
Thank you for that.
Yeah.
Thank you for that.
Yeah.
Y'all want to hear him sing?
Yeah.
Do you want to hear him sing?
Yeah.
Here it is.
Okay.
I'm from way, way beyond time and space. It's my job to study planets and their meaning. Then one day I was tasked, trust I did not ask, to come to Earth and learn about human beings. I need the smartest on the planet to help me understand it, and that's why I've come to you. Now teach me all about
humans. See there. Come on. You got a voice there.
Thank you.
We've been treated to your voice before.
Sure.
What's
Love Got to Do with It? I did my singing, and I sang on an episode of... there he is. There's that guy.
Yeah.
I remember him.
And you really sang.
Yes.
That was really your voice.
That's really my voice.
And Pee-wee's Playhouse,
yeah. I sang on an episode of that. It's Cowboy Curtis. Yeah.
We're going into the vault for you, man.
You guys are going deep.
We're going deep.
Yeah.
But what is it like to have a theme song, though?
It's cool. It's very cool. I mean, you know, listen, we'll see how people respond to it. I mean, some people have said, I couldn't get the song out of my head. And I was like, I'm so sorry.
A little bit of an earworm. But speaking of What's Love Got to Do with It?
Yes.
Your co-star, Angela Bassett.
Yes.
Both of you were nominated for an Oscar.
We were nominated for Oscars for that performance. She's just been nominated for Wakanda Forever. And I'm hoping and praying that she actually gets to take the trophy home.
And the first Marvel character.
That's right. That's right.
That adds to it.
Well, I mean, she's incredibly strong in the movie. I mean, nobody plays a queen better than Angela.
And the queen herself.
Yeah, and so I think it's just only right and fitting. I mean, I was so happy to see that she won the Golden Globe, and I'm very excited for her, you know, the possibility that she finally gets to take home an Oscar.
And we're excited about you teaming up with Keanu Reeves again.
Yeah, John Wick 4 comes in about 3 or 4 weeks or something like that.
Some martial arts?
Some martial arts. Definitely some martial arts in the movie. Not that I'll be doing any of that. I let Keanu handle all that nowadays. But no, this I think this is going to be the best of all the John Wick movies.
All right. Well, you are the best, my friend.
Thank you, Robin.
Thank you. Always bring it. And we want everybody to know that Marvel's Moon Girl and Devil Dinosaur premieres this Friday on the Disney Channel and February 15th on Disney Plus. Well, hey there, GMA fans. Robin Roberts here. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Lots of great stuff here. So go on, click the subscribe button right over here to get more of awesome videos and content from GMA every day, anytime. We thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the morning on GMA.